Good evening, everyone. My name is Destiny Williams, and welcome to Petaluma Blacks for Community Development Black History Program. We are glad you chose to join us. First, I would like to acknowledge our being on Native American land. We gratefully acknowledge the Native people on whose ancestral homeland we gather, as well as the diverse and vibrant Native communities who made their home here and in neighboring communities. We acknowledge that the Coast Miwok called this land home before the arrival of other people. We recognize the Miwok as the original stewards of the lands on which we now live. We will now have a prayer by Shane Woodleaf, lead pastor of New Life Christian Fellowship.
Father, we come before you today, and we're thankful that your word says that you give every good and perfect spiritual gifts to us. You bless us on top of blessing, on top of blessing, on top of blessing. And so, Father, we want to pause this evening and just say thank you for your blessings. Father, your word also says that you are love, that you're not a God of division and hate and animosity and unforgiveness, that you are a God of love. And so, Father, I pray that we would be people who are agents of your love. There's too much hate in our world, too much prejudice, too much anger, too much frustration. And Father, your plan is for us to expand your kingdom by loving one another. And so, Father, I pray that tonight will bring us forward into better ways of loving each other. Father, I pray that the more that we do love each other, that your kingdom of love would expand here in Sonoma. Father, we are so thankful. In your name I pray. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Shane. It is with great honor and gratitude that we take a moment to acknowledge the remarkable individuals who stand at the very foundation of our organization. Ms. Gloria Robinson and Faith Ross, can you both stand, please? Let's give them a round of applause. We also want to honor any city council officials who might be in the audience. Please stand. Thank you all. And now our Grapevine Youth Leadership Program will perform for you. As you may know, this group is sponsored by Petaluma Blacks for Community Development. Grapevine was started in 2021 and is open to all Black students 12 to 18. Will the Grapevine students who aren't performing tonight please stand? Thank you. We will now have Christy Boblett come and introduce the youth.
Hi, everyone. My name is Christy Boblett, and I am one of the co-founders of the Grapevine Youth Leadership Program. The program was created to address the needs and desires of Black youth in Sonoma County for representation, peer connection, and a chance to build leadership skills in a supportive setting. The group was designed to help our youth develop their confidence and skills as community leaders, while also providing them with opportunities to see themselves reflected in adult leaders and professionals who share their race and culture. Over the past 3 years, our youth have met and learned from many different Black professionals and leaders, and have also learned how to use their voices to enact changes in our community. The Grapevine youth have given back to the community through service projects, such as food distributions and starting a garden to provide for people facing food insecurity in our community. They also continue to go to multiple field trips each year to museums, music and theater productions, and even went for a week-long trip to Washington, D.C. last summer for a Black history-focused experience. Of course, they also have a lot of fun and enjoy interacting with peers who share their experiences. We do have space for up to 20 youth per session, and there is a flyer in the back if you guys are interested about the program. Tonight, some of our members will be presenting performances from different areas of art, including dance and poetry. These amazing youth are excited to share their perceptions and experience with you through their own artistic performances, while also celebrating the many Black artists and artistic movements that have inspired them. To start our performances tonight, we have Lilia Boyd. Lilia will be performing a poem by Phyllis Wheatley.
Hi, I'm Lilia. I'm gonna do a brief explanation of the background of the woman whose poem I'm going to read. Her name was Phyllis Wheatley. She was a slave originally from Africa. She was taken and sold into slavery at the age of 8 to a Mrs. John Wheatley in Boston. She learned English extremely fast and quickly developed a talent for poetry. She ended up being one of the first successful female African-American poets in America. The following poem is from her book titled The Poems of Phyllis Wheatley that was published in 1773. It's called A Hymn to Humanity. Lo, for this dark terrestrial ball, forsakes his azure-paved hall, a prince of heavenly birth. Divine humanity behold, what wonders rise, what charms unfold at his descent to earth. The bosoms of the great and good with wonder and delight he viewed, and fixed his empire there. Him, close compressing to his breast, the sire of gods and men addressed, my son, my heavenly fair. Descend to earth, there thy throne to succour man's afflicted son. Each human heart inspire to act in bounties unconfirmed. Enlarge the close contracted mind and fill it with thy fire. Quick as the word with swift career, he wings his course from star to star and leaves the bright abode. The virtue did his charms apart, then thy raptured heart perceived the rushing god. For when thy pitying eye did see the languid muse in low degree, then at thy desire descended the celestial nine, or me methought, thy deign to shine and deign to string my lyre. Can Africa's muse forgetful prove, or can such friendship fail to move a tender human heart, a mortal friendship laurel crowned, the smiling graces all surround with every heavenly art. Thank you.
Next we have Alira Ali Appling, who will be doing her own interpretive dance to Teo Cruz, Dynamite. Ali sees this song as a celebration song and allows her to do as she wishes to do. Dance has a deep history in the Black community, and while many other groups have embraced much of the Black dances and style, interpretive dance is still very individualistic and is all the dancer's own. Dancing is always part of the Black community's celebration, and it shows that nothing can or will hold us back.
I came to dance. I hit the floor, cause that's my plans. I'm wearing all my favorite brands. Give me some space for both my hands. You, cause it goes on and on and on. And it goes on. Sometimes saying, ayo,
came to move, 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 move. Get out the way of me and my crew, 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 crew. I'm in the club, so I'm gonna do, 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 do. Just what the phone came here to do, 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 do. Yep, yep, cause it goes on and on and on.
This year in Grapevine Youth Group, our theme has been, Your Voice is Your Power. The youth adopted that theme after their Washington, D.C. trip, where they learned how powerful one person's voice can be for creating change. We have also been focusing on how to use art, such as poetry, as your voice, and how poetry can be a way to change perspectives, share ideas, and bring about change in society and the world. Our next two performers, Azalea Abrams and Nina Boblett, will be sharing their original poems and voices with you.
Hello, my name is Azalea Abrams, and I'm a seventh grader at Rincon Valley Middle School in Santa Rosa. Today, I will be reading a short poem created by me called The American Dream, which highlights the struggles of our world today. Okay. Is life really the American dream? Waking up only to hear that breaking news, Dr. Martin Luther King has been killed, George Floyd has been murdered, Rosa Parks has been arrested, and so on. How is it that these tragedies just keep happening? Haven't we yet learned that there's no such thing as race? None. There's just a human race, scientifically, anthropologically? Toni Morrison. Definitely not, but at least we can all do our part in making our world a better place. So let's recreate and turn back all the violence and hate that this world so unnecessarily penetrates. That would be my American dream. Thank you.
My name is Nina Boblett, and this is my poem, Longing for Equality. No matter the struggle, no matter the suffering, Black artists magnified the hardships of the African-American population in this country. They expressed the unequal treatment of Blacks through paintings, poetry, and music. Like a rose growing through a crack in the cement, they persevered through the racism and expressed the rich cultures of Blacks in this country. Using their popularity, Black artists were the voices of those who were overlooked and ignored, activists fighting for their rights, knowing that their hard work would someday result in a better world, one where people who looked like me would be allowed the same rights as their white peers, one where I was given similar opportunities as my white peers, and one where I wasn't discriminated against simply because of my beautiful dark skin. We still have a lot of work to do in this country, working towards true equality, which I'm not sure if I'll even see in my lifetime. But I can say, Thank you to authors like Zora Neale Hurston for not fearing and what the repercussions would be of demonstrating such courage and strength. Thank you to artists like Jean Michel Bascott for representing the unspoken and disregarded issues of our society. And thank you to poets like Amanda Gorman for creating poems that I can turn to when I rely and seek in guidance. In the wise words of Maya Angelou, still I rise. Still I rise against the stereotypical standards placed on me. Still I rise against the racism I experienced in school. And still I rise from the box society so badly wants to keep me in. Thank you.
Our final performance explores the history of breakdance and its connection to Black culture, with a breakdance performance from Grapevine member Michael Shaw.
Hey, I'm Michael Shaw. I'm here to give you all a brief history of breakdancing, and then I'm gonna do a little breakdancing for y'all. So back in the late 60s, early 70s, hip-hop really started to shine. That's when people started doing it and all, and it became very popular. And we got out of hip-hop three main types of dancing. We got breaking, popping, and locking. Now, hip-hop comes from jazz, I guess you could say, and it's all part of the African diaspora, which leads us to this. Breaking is definitely one of my favorite types of dance because, I like all the cool stuff they do. So, you know. Without further ado, I'm gonna get started for y'all.
Peace up, A-Town down.
We now welcome Rielis Dotson Newman and Sabria Abdullah, who will perform a libation ceremony to honor our ancestors. Petaluma Blacks for Community Development represents African American in the arts, a journey of our challenges, creativity, and triumphs. The history of the drum. Jazz was created in America by African Americans, but draws from the ancient African cultural traditions of call and response and ring shout. The first Africans transported to this country came from a variety of ethnic groups with a long history of distinct and cultivated musical traditions. Africans in America also fashioned numerous types of drums and percussion instruments from whatever materials they could gather. African American slaves cultivated their own music based largely upon African tradition. This music later evolved into field songs, spirituals, blues, and the many genres of what we now call jazz. As such, while the dominant roots of jazz lie in the African American experience, the seeds of the tree lie in the Africa and the drum. During the early years of slavery in America, drums were used to provide rhythm, but they were banned by the early 1700s on most plantations because of the fear that Africans would use them to communicate in a rebellion. Nevertheless, Africans managed to generate percussion and percussive sounds using other instruments or their own bodies. The drum remains an essential element of the music to this day. We hope this presentation tonight will demonstrate how our survival was dependent upon our expression through our music and our art. As James Brown would say, give the drummer some. I would like to welcome our African performers in Lolo Congo representing Central Africa. Thank you.
From the 15th century through the 19th century, Africans were taken from the continent to be enslaved in the New World. Over 2 million people died during the Middle Passage, and 30 to 60 million people died while enslaved.
Ship ahoy, ship ahoy, ship ahoy, ship ahoy.
I am an African, not because I was born there, but because my heart beats with Africa. I am an African, not because my skin is black, but because my mind is engaged by Africa. I am an African, not because I live on its soil, but because my soul is at home in Africa. When Africa weeps for her children, my cheeks are stained with her tears. When Africa honors her elders, my head is bowed in respect. When Africa mourns for her victims, my hands are joined in prayer. When Africa celebrates her triumphs, my feet are alive with dancing. I am an African. For her blue skies take my breath away, and my hope for the future is bright. I am an African. For her people greet me as family and teach me the meaning of community. I am an African. For her wellness quenches my spirit and brings me closer to the source of life. When the music of Africa beats in the wind, my blood pulses to its rhythm, and I become the essence of sound. When the colors of Africa dazzle in the sun, my senses drink in the rainbow, and I become the palette of nature. When the stories of Africa echo round the fire, my feet walk in its pathways, and I become the footprints of history. I am an African, because she is the cradle of our birth and nurtures an ancient wisdom. I am an African. I am an African, because she is the land of tomorrow, and I recognize her gifts as sacred.
Everywhere I go, there's an angel there.
There's an angel there.
Everywhere I go,
everywhere I go,
there's an angel there.
There's an angel there.
Everywhere I go,
everywhere I go,
there's an angel there. One of the traditions that from Africa to America was something that's called call and response. Call and response songs were utilized for many different reasons. They were able to send signals.
He never leaves me alone. Everywhere I turn,
everywhere I turn,
there's an angel there.
There's an angel there.
Everywhere I turn,
everywhere I turn,
there's an angel there.
Cause my God,
my God,
my God, he never leaves me alone. Everywhere I go,
everywhere I go,
there's an angel there,
there's an angel there.
Everywhere I go,
everywhere I go,
there's an angel there,
there's an angel there.
Everywhere I go,
everywhere I go,
there's an angel there,
there's an angel there.
Ooh, cause my God,
my God,
my God, he never leaves me alone. He'll never leave me alone.
He never leaves me alone.
Everywhere I turn,
everywhere I turn,
there's an angel there.
There's an angel there.
Everywhere I turn,
everywhere I turn,
there's an angel there.
There's an angel there.
Everywhere I turn,
everywhere I turn,
there's an angel there.
There's an angel there.
Ooh, cause my God.
My God,
my God, he my never God. Leaves me alone.
Thank you. Thank you.
hate to see the evening sun go down. I hate to see the evening sun go down. It makes me think I'm going all around, feeling tomorrow like I feel today. I said feeling tomorrow like I feel today. I'ma pack up my dreams and make my getaway. St. Louis woman with her diamond rings, she pulled a man around by her apron strings. Wasn't for powder in the store-bought hair. The man I love would not go nowhere. I got the St. Louis blues, and I'm blue as I can be. He got a heart like a stone that I cast in the sea. Or else he would not gone so far from me.
Let's give Julie Dormeyer another round of applause. Now, if you could all rise, we will have Minister Kevin Miner lead us in our Negro National Anthem.
Don't know if you can see me, but I can see you. Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicings rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Sing a song of a new day, let us march, brought us. Facing the rising sun of a new day begun, let us march on till victory is won. God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, thou who has brought us thus far on. Let us into the light. Keep us forever in the path, we pray. Lest our feet stray from the places our God will remit thee. Lest our hearts, drunk with the wine of the world, we forget thee. Shadowed beneath thy hand, may we forever stand true to our God, true to our native land.
Southern trees bear strange fruit. Blood on the leaves and blood at the root. Black bodies swinging in the southern breeze. Strange fruit hanging from the poplar trees. Pastoral scene of the south, the bulging eyes and the twisted mouth, scent of magnolia, sweet and fresh. Then the sudden smell of burning flesh. Here is a fruit for the crows to pluck, for the rain to gather, for the wind to suck, for sun to rot, for the tree to drop. Here's a strange and bitter cry.
Thank you. Sugar Hill, way up in Harlem. If you should take,
if you should take
a train, you get to where you're going in a hurry. Hurry, 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 now it's coming. Should miss
Rihanna.
The train.
Rihanna.
You
Rihanna.
Miss the quickest way to get to Harlem.
Rihanna.
And she is going to recite her poem that she performed for MLK Day. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Layla Parrish. I'm a senior at Rancho Cotati High School, and this is my speech. We must learn to live together as brothers or perish together as fools. The quote says something very important when it comes to activism in its relation to our world. The oppression of all communities is entangled, even if it presents differently in others. The only way to advance is by advocating for all marginalized groups. For this to work, radical love needs to be demonstrated. In MLK's activism, he stood for this fact, and that's what made his work not only successful, but admirable as well. Most don't remember King as a radical, but the issues he cared about and his approach to solving those issues made him radical. He knew his views were unpopular, but still saw the importance of fighting for what he believed was right. An element of radical love is inclusion, being able to bring everybody in and advocating for the rights of all, even if we don't fully understand what the struggle of others is like. It's carrying the weight of all people who experience oppression and being willing to do the best for those people. Another element of radicalism is having confidence of what you believe in, no matter what others may have to say. Martin Luther King Jr. presented both of these values in his 1967 speech against the Vietnam War. His speech expanded his activism internationally and broke off the notion that the civil rights movement needed to stay domestic. Even with the threat of losing allies, he continued with the speech because it was his true belief. And in his heart, he prioritized all groups of people, making that speech very important to his legacy. Another example of King's radicalism was his view on capitalism. The way he spoke on capitalism was and still is wildly unpopular. However, his insight connected the dots of economic inequality with racial inequality. On March 30th, 1967, King spoke at the Southern Christian Leadership Conference. He said the evils of capitalism are as real as the evils of militarism and racism. The problems of racial injustice and economic injustice cannot be solved without a radical distribution of political and economic power. He also disputed the idea that capitalism developed from hard work and independence in his speech, The Three Evils. Again, we have deluded ourselves into believing the myth that capitalism grew and prospered out of the Protestant ethic of hard work and sacrifices. Capitalism was built on the exploitation of black slaves and continues to thrive on the exploitation of the poor, both black and white, both here and abroad, he said. People don't comment on these opinions of Martin Luther King, and I believe it is because it is easier to label the progress he made as non-radical. It takes accountability off of individuals and allows us the luxury of not thinking critically about the injustices in our world and how we should solve them. Generally, people don't remember these speeches from Martin Luther King. In fact, most people don't remember him as a radical at all. This view of him allows people the ability to forget how King was able to be so successful in his fight for civil rights. Without King's radicalism, true change would probably not have been possible. No change can be made if activists are afraid of the opinions of others. King realized this and was able to make a change. He called for his community to make everyday decisions to create a large-scale movement and change the way Black people were seen and treated. In our present-day world, I believe the most effective way to make change is using radical love. Treating people better on a day-to-day basis, doing small radical actions that are accessible to large parts of our community and that are examples of how people should be treated. I think everyone holding themselves accountable about their treatment of other communities affects and how that affects the treatment of themselves is the best way to make even more progress in our everyday world. In our present and future, we should view activism in the light of, if I don't stand, who will? We should also view all discrimination as equal in affecting our communities, whether directly or indirectly, as that is the only way we'll be able to truly make a change in our world. We should also realize that there is no use trying to water down our beliefs for the sake of others. What we have to say is important, and not fighting for everything will lead to progress in nothing. Just like King told his full truth, so should we. In all this, we should still be open to learning and supporting all communities around us. Thank you.
The Black Power or Revolutionary Movement emphasize Black self-reliance and determination more than integration. The movement focused on combating centuries of harm and humiliation by promoting respect and racial pride. This movement blessed us with artists such as Maya Angelou, James Baldwin, Gil Scott-Heron, Nina Simone, and an anthem declaring our resistance, resilience, power, and pride.
Let's bring back the rhythm department, Williams, who will perform A Change Is Gonna Come.
This gentleman's song, Sam Cooke, been traveling all night, arrives at Shreveport, Louisiana on a winter's night, trying to check in a hotel. They denied him. They said it was a whites-only hotel. At this point, Sam Cooke had been traveling and been staying at many hotels, and they still refused to put up Sam Cooke and his band. So out of the situation, upon many during the civil rights movement, this song was created.
I was born by the river in a little tent, and just like that river, I've been running ever since. It's been a long, long time coming, but I know a change is gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die, 'cause I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long, long time coming, but I know a change is gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Someone keeps telling me You're not wandering around. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change is gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Well, I go to my brothers, and I say, brother, 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 help me, please. But then he rises up, knocking me right back down, knocking me right back down. Here where I belong. It's been a long time coming, but I know change is gonna come. Oh yes it will. Well, it's been a long, long time coming, but I know a change is gonna come. A change is gonna come. A change has got to come. It's a long, long time coming. You know what, folks? We can't keep going on like this. The record has been broken for a long time. We are all God's people. But somehow, a division and a purpose has been put on us. But we can't let that happen. Continue to happen. A change has got to come.
Say it loud.
One more time. Say it loud.
for ourselves. We're tired of beating our head against the wall and working with someone else. Say it loud.
We will now bring back Skylar Palacios with an interpretive dance and Alexei Aronkov on the saxophone.
Fish are jumping and the kiting is high. Oh, your daddy's rich and your ma is good looking. So hush, little baby, don't you cry. One of these mornings, you're gonna rise up singing. Then you spread your wings and you take the skies. But till that morning, there's nothing can harm you. With Daddy and Mammy standing by.
Oh,
the black community. The crack epidemic produced mass incarceration, addiction, and an attack on the black family. It also transformed a genre of music, hip-hop, to help guide us through these dark times. African-American artists created media that would encourage and empower the black community.
Well, we're moving on now. The hate you gave us, I know why the caged bird sings. The color purple, stamped, blue eyes. The new kid, the 1619 Project, and Native Son. During the 1950s, Paul Robeson was banned from concert halls, the stage, movie screens, radio, and television. Billie Holiday's nightclub career was destroyed after she refused to stop singing about the horrific and inhumane practice of lynchings in America. This is a short list of literature and performers caught up in the campaign of repression. We've made a great stride as a people, and our creativity played an integral role, but we still have work to do.
Can we turn on the stage lights, please? First of all, how did you guys like the show tonight? Was it a great show? It was a fantastic show. We had a great performance by the Grapevine Kids, and these are professional performers. And I want to take a couple of minutes to acknowledge these people that have taken time out to come and share their talents with us tonight. I won't name all of their names. I've listed them all, but I've asked everybody who performed please to come back out. So please turn on the house lights, turn on the stage lights. All of them are going to come back out. Please, if you don't mind. Please come on back out. Yep, just come on back out, everybody, please. Everybody who has performed, come out. Faith, I don't know if you want to make any final comments before we cut it up, because the last thing we're going to do is we want you to leave here in a very festive mood. They are about to cut it up. Anybody who has an instrument, doesn't matter. Grab an instrument. If you don't have an instrument, just grab anything that makes a noise. Come on out. Everybody come back out. I want you guys to show these guys your appreciation. You did a great job. Everybody did a great job. Thank you so much. Thank you guys for coming. Thank you guys for performing. This is a fantastic group. And these people, if you want to hear more about them, they have some information on the back. They have information on the back about their various organizations. All right, everybody, let's go. It's a party. Let's go.